Ah, there you are. Hey, everybody. It's Stacy Wells here from Stacy Wells Artistry. I'm back. I've been on a hiatus for some time, taking care of things around here. And since it's Christmas time, I decided to make a couple of videos on what I'm working on. Right now, I'm a mess as usual because I forbid myself from ever wearing a bra or makeup during work time. Okay, it's a no bra, no makeup work time. Is a no bra makeup area. My hair is sort of fixed, but that's because I had something to do earlier today, and I do actually have a little bit of makeup on, but I didn't do that for this video because I don't do that. Anyway, y'all know how I am. These are the ones that I have that I'm almost done with. They still need a little touch up here and there. Let me show you. See, they need a little touching up here and there. And I'll explain how I do these, but if you want to do them, they're different than what I see most people doing. As usual, you know me, I got to be, you know, march to a different drummer. But some of these still need a little work, but they're the only finished products I have to show you. And I was anxious to make this video because everybody's working on these right now, and I wanted to show y'all what I was doing and see what everybody else is doing, yada yada. Anyway, I will say this about this stuff. Let me tilt y'all up just a little bit so I'm not cut off at the top. I hate this new tripod thing I have. It is one that doesn't stand alone. It has to be hooked to the table, which is the primary problem. It doesn't fit a lot of times. If you're looking for a tripod, get those ones that stand alone and have the extensions where you can adjust the height a lot. If you're needing to have one for anything, just FYI, this thing, it's got the bendy arms and everything, and that part is okay, but I've just had trouble with it not wanting to stick onto certain surfaces where I want to record from. It's just not as flexible, not as independent as one that sits on its own. You can put that anywhere. And I want to make a few videos on some stained glass and stuff too. Those of you who enjoy those, I'm going to do some of those. But I wanted to get these Christmas things done because I'm working on this. I figured, what the hell, I might as well video it. Maybe some of y'all are struggling with some of the problems I've had in doing these, and I'll go into that a little bit. I tried alcohol inks with mine, and I've been really disappointed with them. I tried painted on the inside, I painted on the outside. I just was not pleased at all. They came out, well, the paint didn't adhere very well for one thing. I had splotchy open areas. They were ugly, basically. I mean, they were ugly. And so I went back to what I do best. I went back to pour painting. And I tried doing what everybody else was doing, which is painting the inside of the ball. And I used glass balls just because that's what I picked up. And because I had considered using resin on them, and I was afraid the resin would react with a plastic ball. And I think that's a real concern. If you're going to try to resin these, you want to consider the fact that a lot of times resin will react with plastic. I only use paper cups when I'm using resin because of that. And you never know when it's going to happen. You won't know until it's too late. You know, that's the way that always goes. And resin is expensive. You don't want to waste it. So I just use paper cups with resin. I'm probably not going to resin these just because I don't have time. Somebody threw all of ours out last time, and so I have to have enough for our Christmas tree, and that's going to go up this weekend. So I don't have time to fool with all that resining. And there are other concerns with resining these too, but I'm not going to go into that because I'm not doing it. I do have some other things I wanted to show you that I've made that I did resin as Christmas gifts. But I'll go into that in just a minute because I was in the middle of telling you about these issues. I have not had an issue with my acrylic paint adhering to the glass balls. Some people say that they have had problems with paint adhering. I don't know if they mean acrylic paint or if they're talking about the other. Anyway, I have not had that issue, and I paint on the outside because I couldn't get the paint on the inside to work right. It never looked as pretty. The balls tended to mix, overmix. and be gray or brownish, I couldn't get the look I was trying to get. And I think you can tell from looking at these what I'm going for. Like I said, these are not exactly perfect yet. They need some touching up. A couple of them need to be re-poured. And they all need to be, I'm going to put just a glaze over them, a clear glaze, like, you know, well, any of those that you get, just a clear glaze. Anyway, that's what I'm going to do with mine in the interest of time, mostly. The way I have been doing mine to get this to work right is, I'll take you with me and I'll show you outside. Okay, on our way, I'm going to show you a couple of these Christmas things that I've done. This is one right here. It is was just a clear, let me try to get it where y'all can see it actually. Okay, it was a clear bottle that I got from Hobby Lobby. I pour painted it. Well, first I gesso everything. If it's glass, because you don't know. All right, see those? I did those. For gifts, you know, for Christmas. But you don't know if it's glass, if it's going to stick or not. So I gesso everything just to be sure that it's going to stick. And those have been covered with resin after I was done with them. I didn't just put the clear glaze. Here's the clear glaze that I use a lot of times, this Krylon triple thick clear glaze. But most of them work just fine. Now, here's what I'm doing with the balls. Okay. Let's see. Let me flip y'all. This way it works better. I'm no camera expert. Now, see, these I've just poured. And those are dowel rods. And I just put them over the top of the box. That way the box has a plastic trash bag underneath it. So the box and the trash bag catch. You can even put the trash bag around the box, and that way it'll really catch. I'm not that worried about it because I'm in the garage, and I really don't give a shit. But if you did, you could put the trash bag around it where the bag would open up and catch the paint that comes through the box. Anyway, these look better than those in there, I think, because they're just poured. The lighting is just not real good in here. But I think these are acceptable as far as color goes. Let me aim them this way and maybe you can see in the light. I'll just walk out here where the light is. Okay, this is kind of what I'm going for, okay? And these don't have any splotchy places on them. They do not have the clear finish on them yet because they're not dry. Here's my other project I'm gonna tell you about in a minute. Okay, kind of OCD around here. Kind of OCD and ADD, both. I only get OCD about my work. I'm not that way about anything else, but I do get kind of, you know, particular perfectionistic about my work. But anyway, this is the way you do it. You just get those really cheap dowel rods, and I like using the thinner ones. Well, you have to use them a certain thinness because they won't fit through those holes at the top of the balls. But this way, you can keep the balls separated from each other, because if they touch up next to each other, it's going to make a big mess up on it at any point during the process, even at the glazing and all of that. If they stick together, you got a problem, or if they touch up against anything. So those are like real small dowel rods. They're very cheap at Walmart. You don't need to get them at Hobby Lobby. You can get them at Walmart cheaper. And I simply mix my paint and everything, and I pour it over the top of the ball. Now, I'll do another video and I'll show you how I do that, because it's not as, it's not just a, well, I have a technique, let me put it that way. I'm gonna have to charge my phone, and I'll make another video where I mix the paint and actually pour some of them, because there's some differences in the paint mixing. Not really the mix, the way I mix it, but I found that I want to use a whole bunch of colors, and that makes it muddy, okay, as it does in, you know, when you're painting, you know, a regular piece. If you mix too many colors, you're going to get mud. So it's even more a problem, a factor, I should say, with these ornaments, because it's a small surface area that you're working with, and if you put too much or dark colors in there, like black or brown or copper, I like the copper in them, but I was getting some gray colors and stuff like that, and I don't want that. So I narrowed it down to just a bright red, a bright green, this kind of fuchsia pinkish color, because that just makes a little pop in there. I have DecoArt burgundy here and DecoArt gold. And those are the only ones I'm using. And I layer them on top of each other, and I do not mix them anyway. Like, some people might want to stir that a little bit, since when we're pour painting, we dump, you know, we mix our paint some way when we put it on the canvas. You know, we either put it down and wipe over it doing a swipe, or we dump it upside down, you know, doing a flip cup or whatever. I don't do that with this because it makes it muddy. And I don't go for cells so much with these, although I do still use treadmill oil. I'm not really overly concerned about getting cells. I am concerned about consistency of color and absence of mud, technically. So anyway, I'm gonna mix up some of these and leave a couple of them unmixed and show you how I mix mine, and then we'll go pour a couple of them and see. Now, like I said, I do gesso the balls just to be sure that there won't be a sticking problem, because I know that there can be on glass. So I do that. And then we'll talk about those big planks out there too, because you know me, I've never got just one iron in the fire. Always several. You know, it's manic and crazy around here, and I like it that way. So anyway, this is just kind of a video to let you know that I'm going to be making some videos. I'm back. And I appreciate all of y'all that have messaged me and subscribed. Thank you so much. I'm sorry for the hiatus, but there were things that had to be handled that just precluded my being able to get on here for a while. But I do want to make some Christmas videos, some stained glass videos, and then this project out there, which is a mammoth kind of ordeal. And I have videotaped one similar to it before with it's a pour painting. What I did before was a 3-foot by 6-foot plank of birch wood. Now, these are not the same, so I'll go into that later. But right now, I got to charge the phone. When I come back, we're going to talk about mixing the paint and actually pour some over some balls and let you see how I do that. Because I try to pour it a certain way. I don't just dump it on there. I try to let it trickle out in circles. Now, that dowel rod's in the way, so I'll tell you what you do with that. Anyway, I'll be right back. So y'all check these all out. I'll try to label them, but you know, I'm not real good at that. I'll try to label them like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They probably won't work out that way. So you'll just have to watch them all in order to get all the content. It's my secret plan. No, really, I just never can seem to get it done right. Anyway, I'm grateful that y'all are here. Thank you so much. Happy holidays. And I hope you had a good Thanksgiving. Hope everybody's safe and healthy and all that jazz. And I'll be back in just a minute. All right.